Welcome to the Second Circle. This is where the wealthy souls stay forever. You know, the ones who could afford to fill up their crypts with money during their mortal lives.
Makes you wonder why the ectoplasmoid proletariat wouldn't revolt against the oppressive immaterial regime.
Borgovia might be the guiding light in mad science, but some things just won't change around here that fast. And speaking of that, let's get to one of those bridges, quickly.
Van Helsing, the enemy has captured one of our key personnel. We must send a rescue mission.
Thank you.
I'll be back. I bought myself a new pair of shoes. I hope you don't mind. Back to my story. There were tensions between Irina and me, the quarrels of the good twin and the bad twin. When I heard the whispers that on our birthday, my family would throw a ball in honor of her, her only, my wrath knew no bounds. I was an unbearable monster then. Can you imagine that?
I can't even picture you brimming with furious anger.
And that was what led to the most despicable decisions of my mortal life.
To roam this shadow world for eternity? Speak your name and purpose.
My name is Van Helsing, and I'm here to destroy the Faceless Tsar.
I fought him through numerous incarnations, only to be struck down and banished here every time.
And how did you escape from this world to be born again?
I was released by a champion like you, who spoke my name. Oh, I had many.
Tell me yours then, and let's get on with this.
My curse is not to remember, but you can find them at places where I was laid to rest. Will you release me?
All right. I will release you by finding and speaking your name.
Choose carefully. Some of my names bear a terror burden.
Says, here lies Infernalus, a friend buried alive by the Eternal Tsar.
I really must hear the rest of your story. What happened on that fateful evening?
I decided that only I deserved that special occasion, and Irina didn't. My plan was simple and cruel. I gave her a potion that put her to sleep. Then I slipped into her beautiful dress and went to the ball instead of her.
Did your family realize they had been tricked and punished you?
It was worse than that. They didn't even notice I wasn't Irina.
I really don't like where this tale is going.
The tomb says, here lies Albus, the fool who dared the might of the Death God.
We'll meet again on heavenly grazing grounds, my dearest pony. Your Irina.
Where was I with my tail? The ball. What I didn't know was that it wasn't for Irina or me. It was to be a celebration for the Faceless One, including a grand sacrifice.
Your evil family wanted to sacrifice the innocent Irina to their dark god.
Indeed. It's terrible, isn't it? My family was a nest of monsters. I wasn't any better than them, but we all paid the price. Yes. We all did.
They sacrificed you in her place.
When I realized what they were going to do, I panicked. I was shrieking. I told them that it was a mistake. And they laughed. And they cut off my head with the sacrificial silver axe.
I don't even know what to say. I sense something magical around here.
The tomb says, here lies Damnatus, crushed again and again by the Faceless One.
returned. Seek my name, mortal.
Your name is Damnatus.
No, it can't be. You have condemned me to eternal damnation, to haunt this place until the end of time. Kill me!
You can't be killed. There is nothing we can do.